Hello, welcome students. In the last video lecture, I had explained you the third type of measure of central tendency, that is mode, and we had completed exercise 3.5 that was related to mode. Okay, now in this video lecture, I am going to explain few of the typical sums of exercise 3, that is section D and E. Okay, let us read question number 11 of section D, that is on page number 170 of your textbook. Let us read 11th question. The mean of 50 observations is 35. Later on, it was known that the value of one observation was taken as 50, which was wrong. Find the mean of remaining observations by excluding the wrong observations. It means total there are 50 observations and that mean that came, that was 35. Now, one observation that is 50, that was a wrong observation, so we have to find the corrected mean after excluding that observation. Okay, so first of all, we have to find the total of the all the observations, that is sigma x we have to find out. From that sigma x, we have to deduct the wrong observation and again find the new mean or the corrected mean by the corrected value of the sigma x. Okay. So let us see the calculation on the board. As you can see, the first thing that I have written, that is n number of observations that is given to you in the question, that is 50, x bar that is also given to you in the question, that is 35. Okay. So now wrong observation that is 50, that we remove. But that we can remove only after finding the value of sigma x. Okay. So we have to find the value of sigma x by applying the formula of mean, that is x bar is equal to sigma x upon n. Okay. X bar value that is given 35. 35 is equal to sigma x upon n value that is 50. So sigma x is equal to 50 into 35 cross multiplication. So 50 into 35 would come to 1750. That is the value of sigma x, but that is not the correct value. Okay. So from that 1750 we will subtract the wrong observation, that is 50. So now the corrected value of sigma x that came to 1700. Okay. And from n, it has been told in the question that you have to find the corrected mean after excluding that one wrong observation. Okay. So previously there were total observations 50. Now we are excluding one observation. So now the value of n that would come to 49. Okay. So now we have to find the corrected mean by taking the corrected value of sigma x and corrected value of n. Okay. So now we'll take sigma x upon n. Sigma x is equal to 1700 and n is equal to 49. So 1700 divided by 49 is equal to 34.69. So that is the corrected mean after excluding the wrong observation. Okay. So these are very small sums, but they are typical sums and different from whatever the exercises that we have done till now. Okay. So especially I have chosen few of the sums of section D and E that are different from the previous exercises. Okay. Now after completing the 11th sum, I will explain you 12th sum of the same exercise and same section D. Okay, let us read question number 12. Three students from a group of 18 students failed in the examination for the subject of economics. Now there was a test or exam of economics, and out of total 18 students, three students have failed in that examination. Okay, the marks obtained by the 15 students who passed are as follows. The marks of 15 students that are given to you, those who have passed. Okay. Find the median marks of all 18 students. Now what you have to find in this question, that is mean. But you have to find the median of all the 18 students, including the failure students also. So one thing, make it sure students that this type of sum is a raw data. So in case of raw data, we have to apply the formula of median, that is n plus 1 by 2. And whenever you are finding the value of median, see that you are arranging the data in ascending or descending order. Then and then only you can find the correct value of median. So don't forget to arrange the data in ascending or descending order in case of median. Okay. So here you can see I have shown the calculation of the 12th sum. That is, first of all, I have arranged in ascending order all the data, that is from the lower value to the maximum value, total 15 data of passing students that has been given to you. Okay. Now you have been asked to find the median. Now you can see from the question itself that it is raw data. So in case of raw data, we have to apply the formula, that is n plus 1 by 2 to find the median. Okay. So n value that came, total 18. We have to not find the median of only 15 students here. We have to find the median of all the 18 students. Okay. So make it clear, we have to write the value of n as 18, not as 15. Okay. So 18 plus 1 divided by 2 is equal to 19 divided by 2 is equal to 9.5 will come. So now 9.5th observation. How we can find 9.5th observation? We cannot take 9th value or 10th value. It is a middle value between 9th and 10th. Now there is no any middle value given to us between 9th and 10th observation. Okay. So we have to find the average of these two observations, that is 9th observation and 10th observation. Now we will see, students, that 9th observation over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. 9th observation is coming 61 and 64, 10th observation. But I have placed over here 53 and 55. The reason I'll be explaining it to you, because there are three students who are failure, and failure students will be having less marks compared to the past students. So they will be having the marks less than 42. Okay, so I'll be counting in ascending order first that three failure students. So that three students failure, this is the fourth one, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, and ninth. So the ninth observation value that will come to 53 and 10th observation that will come to 55. Again, I'm repeating, according to our data, the 9th and 10th value would come 61 and 64. But it has been asked in the question to find median of all the 18 students. So in ascending order, if we are arranging, then the first three students that will come, the failure students. I have not written because the marks of that three failure students are not being given. Okay. So that three students, if I arrange in ascending order, first rank would come, first priority would come of that three failure students. And the fourth one would come of the passing students. So this is three failure students, this is the fourth one, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, and ninth. So this is the ninth observation and this is 10th observation. What is the answer came to us? That is 9.5th observation. So we have to find the average of 9th and 10th observation. So 9th observation that is 53 and 10th observation that is 55. So here you can see I have written value of 9th observation plus 10th observation divided by 2. Students, if in exam, if it is coming that 7.5th observation, then you have to do the average of 7th and 8th observation. If it is coming to you, that is 5.5 observation, 5.5th observation, then you have to do the average of 5th and 6th observation. Okay. So here you have to find the average of 9th plus 10th observation divided by 2. Okay. So 9th observation that is 53. 53 plus 55 divided by 2. It would come to 54 marks. So the median that would come, that is 54 marks. So here very important point is there. Most of the students will be making mistake if they are not counting the failure students in the priority when they are arranging in ascending order. So it is very small sum, but little bit tricky sum. Okay. So that's why I have given this sum purposely. Now moving on to section E, the question number 3 that I am going to explain to you, that is on same page, that is 117. Let us read that question number 3. The number of bags of wheat sold in a grocer shop each day are shown in the following table. Now over here the number of bags that are given to you, that is 25 to 29, that is given in continuous frequency distribution distributed into classes. But from the classes you can make out, students, that the data are of inclusive type. Always we have to find the exclusive classes in case of finding quartiles, medians, deciles or percentiles. Okay. So at present I have kept the data as it is given in the question. That is 25 to 29, 30 to 34, 35 to 39, up till 55 and more. Okay. Total there are 7 classes that are given to you as it is written from the textbook. Now the second column, that is frequency. That is also given to you, that is number of days that I have considered as frequency over here. That is also given to you as it is written from the textbook. Okay. Now the next column that I have to find, that is CF. Now two things you have to find over here, that is Q1 and P4. In case of quartiles, deciles, percentiles or median, always don't forget to find the CF. On the basis of CF only you can find that particular decile class, median class, quartile class or percentile. Okay, so now finding the CF, first one value would be as it is, that is 9. 9 plus 17, 26. 26 plus 32, 58. 58 plus 24, 82. 82 plus 10, 92. 92 plus 5, 97. And 97 plus 3 will come to 100. Again, repeating the same thing, that is the last value of CF should be equal to the total number of frequency, that is 100. Okay, so our answer for CF, that is correct. Okay. Now two things has been asked you in the question, that is Q1 and P4. So first of all, let us do the calculation for Q1. Okay. Q1, there is continuous frequency distribution. So we have to apply the formula, that is N by 4, not N plus 1 by 4. For raw data only, we have to apply the formula, that is n plus 1 by 4. In case of continuous distribution, the formula that would be n by 4. Okay. So what is the value of n? That is 100. So 100 divided by 4 is equal to 25th observation. Now 25th observation that would be coming over here, that is in 26. Okay. So our class for curtail that would be 30 to 34. Now 30 to 34, that is an inclusive class. We have to convert that inclusive class into exclusive class. So how we can convert it? By subtracting. Already in the previous chapters also we have understood that by subtracting 0.5 from the lower limit and adding 0.5 to the upper limit, we can convert the inclusive class into exclusive class. Okay. So here you can see from 30 I subtracted 0.5, it came to 29.5, and 34 plus 0.5 came to 34.5. So our exclusive class that became 29.5 to 34.5. On that basis, we'll calculate the value of curtail by applying the formula. Okay. Now students, you are doing the formula of Q1, that is n plus n by 4 minus c upon f into c. Okay. Now what will take the value of lower boundary point, that is not 30, will take 29.5. Always the exclusive class. Remember this thing. Okay. So 29.5 plus n by 4 already we have found out, that is 25. So 25 minus CF. What would be the coming the value of CF? That is, we have got the answer, that is 26. Above of 26 prior to the class, that would come as 9. Okay. So 25 minus 9 upon frequency of the same class. So frequency of the same class means 17. Okay. So 25 minus 9 upon 17 into class length C, that would come to 5. If you subtract 34.5 minus 29.5, you will get 5. Okay. So class length, that would come to 5. Now 25 minus 9 into 5. 25 minus 9 you will do, it would come to 16. 16 into 5 it will come to 80. 80 divided by 17. Okay. By dividing 80 with 17, you will get 4.71. That value you will add with 29.5. You will get the answer, that is 34.21 bags. Here the unit is equal to in bags. So whatever the answer comes, you have to don't forget to put the unit, that is bags. Okay. Now after completing the finding of Q1, next we have to find out, that is D4. Okay. Now D4 means decile. D4. Okay. So D4 is equal to 4. That is the value of J. So 4 into bracket n by 10. Always deciles that will be divided by 10, percentiles by 100, quartiles by 4. Okay. So don't forget that thing. So 4 into bracket n by 10. So 4 into bracket n, that value is 100. So 100 divided by 10, it will come to 10. So 4 into 10, it will come to 40th observation. Now 40th observation, that would come in 58. Okay. So our class for decile, that would be 35 to 39. Okay. So we have to consider our class, that is 35 to 39. Okay. But again, over here, this is an inclusive class. We have to convert it into exclusive class by subtracting 0.5 from lower limit and adding 0.5 to the upper limit. So here you can see the lower limit that came by subtracting from 35.5, came 34.5, and adding 0.5 to 39, it came to 39.5. So our class, exclusive class, that will come 34.5 to 39.5. Okay. Now we apply the formula to find D4, that is n plus 4 into bracket n by 10 minus CF upon F into C. Now L value will take 34.5, not 35. Okay, mind well. So 34.5 plus 4 into n by 10, already we have found out, that is 40. So as it is, I am writing over here 40. 40 minus CF. Now CF we have to take of the previous class. So previous class CF, that is 26. Okay. So 40 minus 26 upon F. F frequency of the same class, that would come 32. Okay. So 40 minus 26 upon 32 into class length, that would come 5. Okay. Now 40 minus 26 you will do, you will get 40. 40 into 5 it would come to 70. So 70 divided by 32. Okay. So 70 divided by 32 you will do, you will get 2.19. That value you will add with 34.5, you will get 36.59 bags. So in this way, you have to find Q1 and D4. Here the very important or different point is there. Here all the classes that has been given in inclusive classes, and that we find the value of Q1 and T4. So this was a new point in the sum. That's why the sum was different from the previous exercises. So students, that's all for today. In the next video lecture, I'll be explaining you such few of the typical sums of section F. Till then, goodbye. Keep practicing. Stay blessed.